So, jetzt können wir mal ein paar Fragen stellen. Fangen wir mal einfach an mit Where is Solaris?
What bugs me is this surface dwellers thing. It's as if Solaris is in another location. Like up in the clouds or something.
Yes, well. Etranunk, the capital of the Solaris Empire, is located in the skies above. Solaris is separated from the land by dimensional distortion fields known as gates. Passing between the two requires special means of transportation, such as an airship. To get to Avi, we stowed away on a regular flight to the surface. I came much later than Sigurd did, but I also escaped in the same way.
What are lambs?
Lambs is the word Solarians use to indicate those who live on the Earth. As I said before, such surface dwellers or Earth dwellers are used for manual labor there. Manual labor could be anything from soldiers to administrative jobs. Solaris gathers its workforce from the land dwellers. Jobs are divided up by who is most suitable. Sometimes people are brainwashed.
Brainwashed?
When you young master were still an infant, I was used as a test subject. There was probably something they valued inside of me.
You too, Doc?
No, I was born in the lower city levels. It is not a complete secret, but I guess I am a Solarian. You see, you still need people to run a country. No matter how scientifically advanced you are, you have no support without people. Pure Solarians are rare. They would not even make up a quarter of Avi's total population, so they support their country by stealing surface dwellers.
Who is that man?
Womit er Ramsus meint. His name is Karan Ramsus. As you know, he is the Gebler commander.
Ramsus.
We call him Kar. In Solaris there is an officer training school called Jugend. He became the commander after leaving there. He is a lower level citizen, the same as me. However, with his amazing abilities, after graduating he rose through the ranks with unparalleled speed. That man had one ideal, to achieve a consolidation of all his colleagues. Even land dwellers, if they had talent, were brought into the army.
So you two were picked by Ramses?
No, we were not picked by him, we aligned ourselves with him.
At that time, we agreed with him.
At the time, Ramses was our hope. He had high ideals and wanted to change the system in Solaris. To us, test subjects and lower level citizens. To us test subjects and to us lower level citizens, he was truly all that we wished for.
A benefactor?
Yes, even I, a test subject, was changed by his ideals.
So why was it that you wanted to flee from Solaris?
We were placed in key military positions by Ramses. And thanks to that, we came to know the relationship between Solaris and the surface dwellers.
The lambs, right?
They weren't just using us lambs for slave labor. They also selected some of us, like me, to be used as subjects in experiments to refine their drugs. Drugs that change people's personalities to make them more aggressive and to draw their latent abilities. They were using us as human guinea pigs to test their psychological alteration drugs.
Human guinea pigs? Experimenting on humans?
Yes, for example. Drive. That drug and all others like it that are used now are byproducts of human experimentation. However, the role of such experimental subjects was not limited to just that. This drive drug is something that anyone in the Solaris army can use, right?
At least anyone in the Gebler forces who is sent to the surface.
You worried about her, huh?
They mind Ellie.
I saw some in her room.
No.
Anyway, using slaves as guinea pigs, how low are these guys? Damn. Okay, I understand. I think I get most of it. Old Mason, go reserve the town hall for us. We'll finish talking there. I'm going outside to get some air.
I should have been honest with him sooner. It is best not to worry about it. You did all you could at the time. The young one will understand.
Da haben wir ja tatsächlich mal so ein bisschen, ich will nicht sagen Antworten, aber mal so ein paar Hintergrundinformationen bekommen. Es war trotzdem nur so die Schneeflocken auf der Spitze des Eisberges bisher. Aber immerhin wurde mal irgendwas so ein bisschen erklärt. Zum Beispiel, warum es immer Lambs heißt und Surface Dwellers. Wo ist denn jetzt die Brücke, zu der ich hingehen muss? Da schon mal nicht. Da. Augenblick. Okay. Ja, doch. Alles noch okay.
I had no idea Sig had such a past.
Are you still suspicious of Sigurd?
Well, I mean, it was just so sudden. I kind of expected to hear something different, like that we were childhood rivals or something. But that's nothing compared to the story he just told us, is it?
So hearing his story has you confused because it was not so simple. There was a time when he was cooperating with one of Gebler's generals. Furthermore, behind Gebler was a country that you had never even heard of.
Hey, what are you picking on me for?
No, I am not picking on you or blaming anything on you. What I am saying is this. If you think about how he feels, then you should see why he could not talk about this with you till now. Looking at the activities of Solaris toward other countries up until now, it has never gone beyond simply maintaining their own empire or self-preservation. And as you have seen, their military power is immense. So Sigurd was probably thinking ahead. First, he was probably concentrating on taking care of the problems here of the continent of Ignis. Once things were settled here, it would give him a stronger foundation to deal with Solaris later, which is a much better plan than rushing straight into a war he knew we could not win. Quite logical, really.
Sounds like you understand one another pretty well.
Well, it is not like we are newly acquainted, is it? And we had talked about a lot of things up until we decided to escape from Solaris.
Speaking of that, why did you leave? The Ramses guy was supposed to be a star of hope or something, wasn't he?
Yes, I certainly thought it so at first, but then I realized his way of thinking really was not that much of a change from the previous system. Basically, the only difference was whether they stressed people's rank and class or their skill. The words had changed, but it was still no different from what Solaris itself had been doing until then. He had no intentions of bringing everyone a better way of life.
In other words, he's an elitist. I don't think I like him much either. So, Kitan, do you think I can beat Gebler?
Why? Are you planning on fighting them?
As long as they're working with Shakan, there's no way around it. The way things are going, I'm sure we'll have to fight them sooner or later.
I suppose so, but even if we were to defeat the Gebler forces here, there is still Solaris to deal with. If we are not careful, it is possible that we may get involved in a longer war than that with Sakaan. Do you not agree that continuing the way we have been going is rather hard on everyone? I think it is time we try to get help from a greater number of people.
So defeating Sakaan is not going to get rid of the likes of Gebler. I know what you're trying to say. To vanquish Gebler, first gain thy throne, right?
Man, ich kann es nicht aussprechen hier.
You could put it that way.
What do you mean, you could put it that way? Then again, maybe it is time I did something about that.
So, ich glaube, jetzt können wir in diese Halle zur weiteren Lagebesprechung. Ah ja, hier.
I went to the tool shed, a shop, to borrow a table.
Wow, du hast einen Tisch mitgebracht. Glückwunsch!
The owner said, if we need anything for the young master, just ask for it.
I'm grateful. When I was a kid, I borrowed stuff from there and got in big trouble.
Borrowed?
I meint wohl eher stealed. Stole.
What did you take?
A toy boat. I think that's what it was.
I put fireworks in it and let it float on the cathedral's lake. I always used to play Navy.
I'm not sure, but I think I pretended the lake was the open sea and I was the fleet commander. Anyway, forget those old stories. We should get started. First, Gebler is the big problem.
Yes, Ramses is headed towards achieving his goals, but he is now the commander of Gebler is proof of that. A normal man could not progress so quickly through that country's organization. And now he is presently located here in Ignaz. Frankly, the situation is not very favorable. We need to somehow find a weak spot and attack it with all our might.
First, let's just concentrate on Sakaan. Once he's out of the way and Avi is safe again, we can think about how to deal with Gebler. With our present strength, we should be able to hold off the Royal Guard forces. The problem is how to deal with Gebler in the meantime. They will most likely move at Sakaan's request, and they're not just gonna sit by and watch quietly.
May I have a look there, please?
In short, we want Gebler to leave for a while, at least until we are able to take back the royal capital Bledervik.
Kriegen wir sogar eine Karte dazu.
These are the Gebler units currently in Avik, correct?
Ich glaube, die gelbe, sich drehende Pyramide unten ist die Hauptstadt von Avik, Bledervik. Das rote, drehende Pyramidending ganz oben ist die Hauptstadt von Kislev, Nocturne. Und die gelben Tetris-Teile sind Gebler units.
The Western Guards? The Royal Capital Defense Force. And units along the front line at the border with Kislev.
Also drei große Tetris-Klotz-Einheiten.
There are three main groups. Each is made up of a mix of Gebler and other forces. Only two of these are very large.
Ach echt? Ah, okay, die zwei.
The Royal Capital's Defense Units and the Kislev Border Units.
Macht ja auch Sinn. Die wollen die Hauptstadt verteidigen und die Grenze zu Kislev.
The Western Guard along Nisan's border are little more than a surveillance team. In order to recapture the Royal Capital, it will be necessary to draw these defense units away from Bledervik. We have some Kislev-made gears, correct?
Yeah, we captured some earlier.
What if we use those gears to make a raid on the Western Guards, here at the border with Nisan?
I see, we'll draw them out by making it look like Kislev is invading Ave from there.
But the problem is, will attacking the border guards be enough to set the center in motion? To be sure, then Nisan will just have to appear to align with Kislev. If they see it that way, they will certainly make a move.
You're saying that you intend to use Nissan as bait?
Doc.
Shao Kahn is very sensitive to Nissan's and Kislev's actions. If Nissan starts moving, he will probably leave it up to Gebler, but...
Of course, I do not wish to do that from the beginning, but looking at the situation, we have to be willing to go that far.
First, we infiltrate into the capital. To take out Shao Kahn, we'll have to meet up with our agents already in the city.
We are forgetting one thing. The frontline units along Kislev's border.
Da oben rechts der gelbe Tetris-Klotz.
The main strength of Abe's fleet is the battleship Cafainsel. It's been in service since the reign of the last king. Because of its firepower, the whole unit is nicknamed the Invincible Fleet. I recall yesterday's intelligence report said that the ship is near the border.
Na wunderbar.
Damn, that puts everything in jeopardy.
Do not feel so down. I simply wanted you to see the current distribution of force in the area. Even the worst case, though, if they do come, it will not be such a great problem.
What do you mean?
I have some additional information about Avi's border fleet. The former Avi Supreme Commander was transferred there. Not really transferred, more like demoted. His name is Wunderkaum.
Das war der mit dem Kreuz im Gesicht, den man letztes Mal gesehen hat, der offenbar ein totaler Idiot ist und alles versucht mit seiner großen, nicht sehr beweglichen Kanone abzuknallen.
Wunderkaum? You don't mean the Wunderkaum that was in Jugend?
The very same. Young one, he has not been able to adapt to the change in tactics, particularly following the introduction of gears. He is a man who will never stray from his dependence on large naval guns.
You mean he's stubborn? He's all size and no real military power, an excellent target for pirates.
Young master, this is not going to be an act of piracy.
Just kidding.
Actually, the number of gears assigned to the fleet seems to have been reduced. Even with that, how gallant of him to be so self-righteous.
Gallant? Jelland? Bin mir gar nicht sicher, wie man das ausspricht.
Is he that much of a musclehead? It'll be fun taunting him.
Young master!
I know. Anyway, Kitan, do you think you can strike our gear forces?
It is not a problem. Even with Wunderkaum, we have enough forces left to pull off the feint. However, it would not be wise to underestimate our opponents.
Voll die Taktik Session hier.
Well, now that we know what we are up against, here is what we will do.
Ja, dann bin ich ja mal gespannt.
Apart from our main unit heading for Bledavik, die Hauptstadt, we must keep the fleet at the Kislev border from returning to the capital.
Also angreifen.
So you're suggesting we have another unit?
A few effective soldiers to hold off the enemy at bay, a small force is best.
A small force.
What if they lead a group of gears there?
Was? Ich?
Me? Hold on now. There's no reason to involve you all in this.
I'll do it.
Yes, let me do it. When do we leave? Are you sure?
We've come this far. Hey, we're friends to the end now.
Speed is everything. We should do this as soon as possible.
All right, tomorrow.
Okay.
I am truly grateful, Faye, Kitan.
There's no way we can lose. No one will die in vain.
Well put, young master.
Puh. Ehrlich gesagt fand ich dieses Taktikgespräch immer so ein bisschen langatmig. Also es war ganz interessant, aber halt auch so ein bisschen, hat sich ein bisschen hingezogen. Aber immerhin gibt es einem einen guten Hintergrund, um zu verstehen, was wir vorhaben. Und immerhin geht's dann jetzt bald gut ab. Wobei ich vermute, dass wir das heute nicht mehr hinkriegen, was da so abgeht.
Good morning. What's with the long face? Not feeling well? Or are you feeling sad about saying goodbye? Or maybe you're just nervous?
Shut up, stupid. Don't bug me.
Mm-hmm.
Oops.
Well, it's almost time.
Yeah, yeah. Is everyone ready to go? I'll be waiting here, so let me know when you're through preparing.
Dann gehen wir mal eben schnell gucken, was wir uns hier noch so für Gearteile holen können.
There is a near wind blowing today.
Ja? Ja, das war, wo wir vorhin waren. Da? Irgendwo ist hier ein... Hier ist es. Ich glaube, der da.
The old man from Gun Room sent me here for supplies. If you want, I can also get gear parts you may need. Just tell me.
Sehr gut. Schauen wir mal, das haben wir jetzt schon eine ganze Weile nicht mehr gemacht, ne? Z9500. Cool, das heißt, wir haben mehr Output. 9 statt 6 und außerdem mehr Fuel. Nehme ich. Frame 3000, also 500 mehr als jetzt. Nehme ich. Armor 9 statt 7,5. Nehme ich auch. Und auffüllen. Kitans Gear, Heimdall. Der hat schon die Engine. Ach, Frame gibt es hier eh nur die für Faye. Armor kaufen wir für ihn auch nochmal. Und dann Fuel auffüllen. Bart hat auch eine neue Engine. Frame hätte ich gar nicht gucken müssen. Und mehr Armor. Dann noch aufladen. Gibt es hier irgendwelche coolen Waffen? RNG Whip. Oh, Snapper Whip. Kaufe ich. Irgendwelche coolen Teile. Mir geht. Oh, ich habe gar nicht mehr so viel Geld. Aber ich sehe jetzt eh nichts Gutes hier. Irgendwas, was ich verkaufen kann. Nein, nicht wirklich. Höchstens Barts alte Waffe, wenn ich jetzt die neue ausrüste. Falls ich das überhaupt gerade. Nee, kann ich gerade nicht machen. Muss ich dann dran denken, wenn ich Bart wieder im Team habe. Mal gucken, ob es hier noch irgendwas gibt. Items. Mal neulich schon mal auf. Oh, es gibt jetzt Aquasol S. Aquasol. Das normale Aquasol gibt einem 50 HP und S 150. Da kaufe ich mal ein paar von. Rose Soul gibt einem EP zurück. Da gibt es auch ein besseres von. Da kaufe ich auch mal ein paar von. Und dann habe ich schon kein Geld mehr. Aber ja, mal gucken, ob ich nicht irgendwas verkaufen kann. Eyeball kann man verkaufen. Auch Scales auch, die geben auch gut was. Das war's. Gibt es irgendwelche alten Waffen? Leather Whip kann ich verkaufen. Wedding Dress könnte ich verkaufen. Ich glaube, den werde ich auch eh nie anziehen. So. Dann kann ich nämlich noch ein paar Cetasol kaufen. Das sind die Phönixfedern sozusagen. Die hatte ich ja neulich, ist aufgefallen, dass ich so gut wie keine davon habe. Und das ist auf Dauer natürlich nicht gut. 4 hiervon und hiervon auch nochmal 2. Dann habe ich von beiden 5. Ach, machen wir 10 draus. So. Gut. Speichern. Speichern könnte ich im Spiel auch mal wieder. Mit der schönen Memory Card. Dann können wir mal gucken, wie weit wir jetzt noch kommen. Sobald ich wieder finde, wo ich hergekommen bin. War das nicht hier? Hier war's.
Are you ready?